It's a good day to talk about the early Renaissance period. Let me give a brief introduction. Early Renaissance period is from European history from 14th to 17th century. The artistic movement started in Italy in the late medieval period. It spread to the rest of the Europe, marking the beginning of the early modern age. Besides, the Renaissance period occurred in the Florence, Italy in the year of 15th century. Before anything else, we will be tackle the characteristic of movement in early Renaissance.
People from the 15th century of Florence believe that they are already living in the so-called New Age. The word Renaissance comes from the word rebirth.
For some reason which remains vague, it happens in Florence to take up the old ways of thinking when it comes to philosophy, religion, and in art. In simpler words, to begin a new way of thinking. The chosen model by the Florentine artists and intellectuals for this new approach was the classical antiquity. Why? Because they believed that Greek and Roman art composed an ideal standard of artistic volume. Furthermore, the early Renaissance art was instrumental for the change of the world. There are top 5 characteristics of the artistic movement that emerged in the early Renaissance.
Number 1 is a positive willingness to learn and explore. Because of the unique discoveries, the artist needs to learn more and seek more on what art is all about. So that is why all the artists in Florence became more curious and want to learn more so that they could explore all the possible aspects of nature.
One cultural movement called humanism began to gain momentum in Italy during the 14th century. What is humanism? It was a way of thinking which adheres more to a man and less significance to a god. Even though Christianity remained the only religion, humanism reconstructed it so as to give it a human face. Humanism in the early Renaissance became an instrumental to the power of the period because it is predominant. Such examples are the religious figures like evangelists, saints, apostles, and the Holy Family were depicted as actual people rather than generalized and ideal figures.
Early Renaissance paintings seek to accomplish greater realism in all of their works. In despite of the flat, rigid images of Byzantine art, in the early Renaissance, faces appeared to be more full of life, bodies were painted in a more realistic and natural poses, and figures seemed to show real emotions. Also, so many efforts were made to put up a realistic depth in paintings using scientific processes. Math, science, and art led to the discovery of perspective in art.
Since the Renaissance period is more unrealistic, the negative perspective of the human body had changed. They believed that the human body is referred to as an art. In fact, it is called a model for God's universe. It welcomed a higher degree of naturalism through putting a highlight on the human figure in observational drawing. Moreover, the period introduces more accurate and spatial coordination of the sculptures, building, and paintings through the innovation of drawing. Subjects for art during the early Renaissance period is based on the study of classical mythology alongside the evolution of portraits and landscapes. It is called humanistic subject matter.
And for the last one, we have secularism. From the word itself, secular, meaning of this world, during the early Renaissance period, the people started to see life on earth as worth living for its own sake, and not just as an ordeal to endure before going to heaven.
Before the Renaissance, Europe experienced a so-called Dark Age, consisting of wars, famine, and the Black Death, or what is also known as the Black Plague. After such a horrible period, the 14th century began and civilization started to advance in science and art. The rise of the Renaissance started when humanism was gaining its momentum during the 14th century, which greatly influenced many different aspects of society in Europe, especially Florence, Italy. Humanism was the idea that man was the center of his own universe, and that society should embrace human achievements in classical arts, education, literature, and science. Florence was the epicenter of the movement, which was supported by the Medici family, a powerful family who ruled Florence for more than 60 years. They were a wealthy, art-loving family, and the establishment of the Medici Bank in Florence by Giovanni de' Medici in 1397 started the investment for the movement for years to come. By the end of the 15th century, the unfortunate demise of the Italian Renaissance was a result of many contributing factors. The Italian peninsula experienced a surge of wars with other European invaders, which led to the scarcity in the region. Wealthy distributors' money was limited because of the economic decline, which also limited them to spend it on arts and agriculture. The Catholic Church and the Counter-Reformation contributed to the downfall of the movement as well. The church strictly censored artists and their work, which constricted their creativity. Because of these factors, the Italian Renaissance died out as the Age of Enlightenment began to make its way into society.
Humanism was a scheme of thought that affixes of more importance to man. To preserve the significance of humanism, all finished work by the artists during the early Renaissance aimed to fulfill the significance of realism. Realism is a way of presenting the work truthfully or naturally that can be seen in real life. Portraits are more authentic, the body's position in the paintings are realistic, and the features convey real emotion that can attract the audience.
There are various remarkable artworks in the early Renaissance. First off is the expulsion from the Garden of Eden. It illustrates the event from the book of Genesis chapter 3. It is made in the year 1427 by Masaccio. It is currently located on the walls of Brancacci Chapel in the Church of Santa Maria del Carmine in Florence, Italy. Its significance is that it portrays an extraordinary emotion realism. It is also created with strongly differentiated areas of light and dark that give them a marked three-dimensional sense of relief, which is new in the early Renaissance. The second artwork is the Annunciation. It is made by Fra Angelico in the year 1440 to 1450 for the decoration of San Marco convent walls, where it is currently located. The Annunciation was the first Florentine altarpiece due to Fra Angelico's use of the perspective. The altarpiece is said to be a reflection of the artist's vigorous interest in entirely new approaches to painting, reshaping the Western art and dominating until the modern age. The next artwork is the David. It is a bronze statue of the biblical hero David. It is made by the Italian early Renaissance sculptor Donatello. It is currently located in Museo Nazionale d'Erbalgelio in Florence, Italy. David was the first major Renaissance sculptor. Many art historians identify it not only as Donatello's most well-known pieces, but also a supreme expression of the Renaissance spirit.
Techniques such as perspective, shadows, and light were used by the artists to add depth to their artworks. Because of significant results, by the end of the 15th century, Renaissance art had reached a high point under the powerful and striving Pope Leo X, hence the High Renaissance. All the art theories developed, styles defined, and new advancements and approaches in painting and architecture introduced in the early Renaissance cultivated the High Renaissance in the late 400s to early 1600s. The early Renaissance was a defining period in history, a time when artistic, social, scientific, religious, and political perspectives all turned into new directions. It laid foundations that integrated the most essential elements and figures that conform correctly to the Renaissance style.